cops. Hey, come on, man. Jimbo's back.
Yowzer! It's that time. Radio was done with him. Four spouses had enough of her and him. Hopefully the third time is a charm. Get ready to have your ear holes.
Let's do it!
It's wild. It's crazy. It's time. It's the Jimbo and Jackie Show.
Yowzer!
And the crowd goes wild.
How you doing, gorgeous?
I'm beautiful.
Excited to be here on the Jimbo and Jackie Show.
Third time's a charm.
Episode 41 is kicking off.
Oh, wow.
And it's going to be a fun 2020, isn't it?
It's going to be a great 2020.
So many cool things. And right now, we're bringing in a legend pretty soon.
Yeah.
We're going to have a very special guest on episode 41. Guitarist Joey Allen from Warrant. Going to be talking about his year and what's coming up. These guys, they've been through it all. They've had the highs, they've had the lows, and they've reclaimed it, and they're still touring all over this great globe of ours. So I'm excited. He was one of the first guys I ever met when I got my radio job in 1991.
What? And I did not know that.
And he was totally cool.
And what's crazy is I found an old cassette because we moved from Grand Taranchi.
Yes.
And I found to Grand Taranchi.
Baby steps.
We're figuring it out. But I found a cassette that said, Fun with Warrant, and I popped it in my cassette player. Yeah, I still got a cassette player in the garage. And it was Joey and his bassist, Jerry Dixon from Warrant, doing station IDs for us. And that was the first to find that cassette. That's like Raiders of the Lost Ark shit,
wow.
Ain't it?
Wow.
So now I'm going to surprise Joey and let him hear some of that fun when he comes in a little bit.
That's awesome, baby.
Yeah.
Did you have any idea what it was when you saw what was written on it?
Yeah, I knew right away.
Oh,
I
you
said,
did?
Ah!
Oh, okay.
Because that was such a great memory. I'm like going, my God, I hope this still held the test of time. From 91 to 2020
still
be on it as bad as now, it's going to be immortalized forever on the internet.
Oh,
unless the internet.
That's awesome.
Is the internet stopping in 2020 or are we going to still have it?
I don't know. They're still looking for coal to fire it up.
Okay, we'll see. So that's going to be exciting. And are you ready to have some fun?
I'm ready, baby.
Okay, I'm going to pop the cork as you make our shamsky, part whiskey, part champagne.
Yeah.
We pop the cork, and what happens?
We get the conversation going and the champagne flowing.
Amen. Here we go. This is from our good friends, Tracy and Mike. Oh, yeah.
Awesome.
Pop goes my love. And I think it's time, baby.
I never get tired of that sound.
It's a sound of celebration.
Yes, it is.
Who doesn't like hearing a cork pop, huh? Amen. You make my cork pop.
Yes, I
do. Very, very much. We cheers you. We cheers everybody as we celebrate this thing called life on the most positively positive podcast on planet Earth.
Cheers, beautiful.
Cheers. Drink along with us.
It never sucks.
Whatever. I know. Damn. Thank you, Mike and Tracy, for the champagne as we made our shamsky. And we kick off episode 41, and Jackie.
Yes.
You got some fun facts about the number 41?
I do have a really fun fact for the number 41.
Let's hear it.
So Jim and I have 7 children between us. I have.
Be smart. Don't start, people.
All 4 of my children were late.
Yeah.
So pregnancy's 40 weeks. I had them in week 41.
Uh-huh.
And so that's what brought me to the number 41. I thought, what in the world would a baby look like if Jim and I had had a child together?
I know, we tried.
And I would be a week late.
So, we were late.
So 41 weeks in, I think I have some photos that,
oh, you got a graphic?
That morphed our faces together.
Oh, you took a picture of me and a picture of you?
Yes.
And that's our child?
There's our little baby. Our little bambino.
It looks like Tootie from the Facts of Life.
It looks like I overcooked it.
Oh, shit.
Well done, Jackie. Well done.
I made us a little well done, baby.
Nice.
So there's our baby at 41 weeks. Beautiful.
We would have kept that. We wouldn't have dropped it off at
the fire station. Look at that little bow tie on his neck.
I could see her in commercials and everything. Before we bring in our very special guest, let's check in with our A-team sound guy, Ashton. How are we doing today? You having a good day?
All good.
All right. Very excited. You got a heavy load because we got a bunch of Warrant song drops that we're going to talk with Joey Allen about how these songs and what memories bring up.
I'm ready, man.
Can't wait to hear it. We're going to do some time travel.
I want
to
hairspray so bad.
Yeah, baby. I should have brought Aquanet. I screwed up. I should have went to Dollar Tree. Emmy Award-winning actors, producer Mark, how are we feeling today?
Fuck Christmas.
All right, there you go.
Damn. I didn't want to say it.
Damn. And a man with the plant. Oh, Ashton, you got something?
I think you're rotten, Mr. June.
And then we got the man with the plan that always explains the Yelp sex positions to perfection. Please give it up for Tay-Tay.
Having a great day, Jimbo. Keeping my spirits high despite Mark sitting next to me. It's going great.
Yep, you're still doing it sitting next to a human lump of coal. I appreciate your spirits high and mighty. All right, there we go. I think another high and mighty. This guy is one of my favorite rock stars I ever met. A down-to-earth dude. Some would even call him a down boy. And the down boys are coming into the Reamp studios of the Jimbo and Jackie show.
Third time's a charm.
Give it up, everybody, for our good friend guitarist Joey Allen of Warrant. Look at this guy. He looks like a rock star.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah. He's got sunglasses. I know, look at you. Are you high as a kite, or you just got sunglasses?
I'm not, man. I'm driving, so okay. I'm pretty sober, unfortunately.
Right on. Well, welcome to the Jimbo and Jackie show.
Thanks for having
What's
me.
Up,
it's
Joey?
Been a while. What's up, Jackie?
Yeah, I love you, darling.
You know what's cool about Joey is he'll support anything I do. My whole resume is on a sticker because I worked at a radio station. He came down to that. I tried to do a PBS show.
Absolutely,
at KVCR, and the pilot's still out there. We're waiting. It's going to hit big any second.
All right.
And then I did a Jimbo and Inman show on Facebook, and I interviewed you guys up at Rockin' Brews at San Manuel.
That's right.
And now you made the trip. What do you think
Always.
About our new studio?
I think it's kick-ass. I like it.
It's
I like
cool.
the headdress, man.
Yeah, that's my Indian bride over
I
here.
Could use that on stage. I'm a little,
I'll totally
a little challenged
it,
up top.
Right on. Well, how was your 2019, brother?
It was great. We just finished a few weeks ago in Jackpot, Nevada.
Is that right?
Have you ever been there?
No.
Where is that?
It's like south of Idaho Falls, Idaho. So you fly in there, and then you drive about an hour south, and it's a casino.
What a perfect name.
Dude, it was great. I mean, we had about, we played 57 shows last year, which isn't a lot for if you're on a big tour, you can do 100 plus, you know?
Right.
But we
Sounds
had,
a lot to
you
me.
Know, about 30 sellouts.
Nice.
It was kick-ass. We did the Dirty 30 tour. It was the 30th anniversary of the first record.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Still doing what you love after 30 years.
Yeah, at least for an hour a day, you know?
Yeah.
The other 23 hours suck, you know? Like hotels and airports and...
Yeah.
And
What's your least favorite airport?
All of them, you it's know. I had 100. I count. You know, I'm such a freak. I count hotels and flights. I had 112 flights last or this
oh
year.
Oh my
you know?
God!
So
man.
It was just. It was. It's just a beating, man. And then you know, you got
it's
the people with their phones, and you know, I'm dropping elbows like 60 flights in. I won't hit people in like wheelchairs.
Yeah.
But if you're standing upright, I'm dropping an elbow.
That's a good man right there.
Or shoulder.
Now, I saw you did, and here in SoCal, I know you did a show with Bret Michaels.
Yes.
Who else did you do shows with?
We did some with Tom Kiefer, Rat. I mean, the whole crew of 80s guys. We're kind of, you know, it's kind of like a fraternity of dudes. You just see each other. You're like, oh, my God, you're still alive.
Yeah.
You know? Who's in the band now, you know?
That's hilarious.
How many original guys do you have? One? All right, let's party. You know?
Sometimes that's all it takes.
I'm telling you, there's two or three versions. You don't know which band you're going to play with, you know?
We're going to get all into that. We want to go through the history to where you're at right now because, man, if you haven't picked it up right now, in case you don't know, the latest album is Louder, Harder, Faster. They got Robert Mason from Lynch Mob.
Cry of Love, yeah.
He crazy. He tears it up.
He's a bad boy. He's a real deal.
He's a lot of fun.
We got lucky. He's been in the band over 10 years now.
10 years it's been?
So I've done, I think, two records with him. Yeah, and we're talking about a third one, so we'll see. It's like moving a mountain, man.
Yeah.
Nobody gives a shit anymore on the record. You know what I mean? It's like a reason to go tour. That's about it.
Yeah, basically. But, sell more merch.
That's it, you know, and it's good for us because then we get to play something fresh, you know, because we're doing the hits, the old stuff that everybody wants to hear. You know, but for us guys that, you know, want to keep it fresh, it's always kick-ass to play some new tunes.
Oh, I bet.
You know? So, yeah, we'll see if we can get it together. And in probably 2 years, we'll spring another one out.
Well, Jim understands. He's playing with a new wife.
I love it.
Third time's a charm, baby.
Yeah. I saw him get all thin and shit. I'm like, damn.
I had to reinvent myself a little bit.
You're looking good, brother.
Well, I appreciate it, man. You're looking good as well. And it's crazy because, like I was telling Jackie a little bit earlier, you and Jerry Dixon were the first rock stars I met when I got that radio gig in 1991.
Oh, shit.
And you guys were so much fucking fun. You could tell that you guys were king of the world.
We were having a good time. That was a good year.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, do you want to... I found a cassette because Jackie and I just recently moved, and I found a cassette that said, Fun with Warrant.
Oh, shit. What could it be?
And I got a little snippet. Usually,
I hope it's not from the back of the bus.
Well, usually when rock stars come to radio stations, the stations always love it when the rock stars say the radio station name. So basically, it's called liners, station IDs.
Yeah.
So they invite the rock stars over, and they say, put a sheet of paper in front of them. Say, hey, can you say how much you love our radio station? And Tay-Tay, do you got that audio? I hope it's, yep. This is
all right.
about 50 seconds long of Joey Allen of Warrant hanging out with Jerry Dixon, who's still in the band.
Yes, he is.
1991, you guys were heading into Palm Springs for a gig, and you stopped in Redlands for a fun little interview. We got you guys pizza and beer, and you did an interview in the afternoon, and then he laid down these fat tracks for our radio station. Go ahead and hit it, Taylor.
Checking mic number one. This is a hell of a lot of fun. We got to do that. We got to start out. 3, 2, 1. Yeah! Good morning! Hey, this is Jerry Dixon.
This is Joey Allen. We're Warren. And when we want a piece in the morning, we're tuned to Samantha. She's our cherry pie. She's on 96.7 KCAL.
With that other dude. Crank it up. Wake up.
Shit.
Yeehaw! What's happening? This is Jerry Dixon.
This is Joey Allen from Warren.
Warren, you're rocking with Stu. Oh,
97.
Stu. Oh, jump back. Kiss myself. Hey, what's going on out there? This is time for weather. Hey, this is Jerry Dixon.
This is Joey Allen. We're Warrant, 96.7 KCAL-FM, Redlands, Riverside, San Bernardino.
The Inland Empire.
Yeah!
Wow, dude.
A little time travel. Is that fun?
That's a trip.
Yeah. But 1991, I've held on to that cassette because I thought it was so cool. You guys, at that moment, 91, what tour was that?
Well, Cherry Pie came out, believe it or not, 9/11 of all dates.
Oh, geez.
Of 90.
Okay.
So next year's 30 years for that record, too. So, so we were on the Cherry Pie tour.
Nice.
That was probably the top of the hill. Right before we jumped off a fucking cliff. Do I remember? Fuck no. Are you kidding me?
Good. I don't want your life to be that unmemorable.
Fuck no. Fuck. I remember some shit, but come on now.
Jesus. You know what? I'm not hurt at all.
That's
by that
29
statement.
Years ago, bro.
Yeah! And I got cassettes, and I remember everything and stuff.
You do remember everything.
I guess it had more of an impact on me, Producer Mark.
Shit.
Yep.
Too much weed's gone through these lungs to remember that far back, bro. You gotta be kind to me.
God, how many radio stations did you guys just pop in and take over? What's it like popping into a radio station when everybody loves your song right there, everybody's clamoring all over you, and they're like going, please.
It's great. I mean, that's part of the gig, you know? I mean, it's everybody thinks, you know, it's the band. The band is huge because it's the band, but it's such a huge village that takes a band to get that big, you know? And radio's a huge part of it. And back then, when radio was a lot different than it is now,
yeah, it was
a
great time for radio.
It was a great
radio.
Time because you could go into a place like when we came in with you guys, it was a fucking blast, you know? And then you go into some CHR, right?
Yeah.
Contemporary Hits Radio, okay? We're going to play Madonna and up next is Warrant. Bullshit, you know what I mean? It was always fun going to rock radio because it was fucking rocking, you know? But you go to CHR and it was a little bit challenged,
right?
You know what I mean? But still, they support.
You want to be respectful, but you appreciate them playing the hit.
You do. You know, you go in there with your tie and your, you know, fucking shit. Anyways, it's all good. It was fun, man. The coolest thing was when they had cherry pie eating contests.
Oh,
okay.
I bet.
And we thought, okay, that's gonna be fucking cool. Until we saw people like eat it. and like regurgitate it, and then
it was like that Stand By Me moment.
Suck it up again, and then no more cherry pie for me. Do you know what I mean? I'm a pecan pie kind of guy.
Which wouldn't sound as good on a song?
I don't think it'd work.
Have you ever changed a word in sound check on cherry pie?
Sometimes live we do.
Yeah, oh, that's
you'll
fun.
Never catch it unless you're really listening.
Yeah, oh, that's hilarious. Well, you know, that's good. You got to keep it.
We've
fun.
All got in-ear monitors so we can hear our mics about like we do right now.
Yeah.
But sometimes we're like, hey, fuck you. Robin will be talking to the crowd and we're like, fuck you.
Yeah. Because you don't work for NASA. Nobody's going to die if you have a little fun.
You got to keep it fun out there, man.
I remember the very first time, guys, I saw Warrant. I didn't know of the band at the time. And it was like, I want to say, you're going to have, maybe you can clear this, but you smoked a lot of weed, so maybe you can't.
Yeah.
88 or 89 at the De Anza Theater in
Riverside. Yeah.
You opened up for Nazareth. And me and my friends were so excited to see Nazareth. We didn't know who was opening. And you guys blew us away because Janie Lane said, we just signed our record deal. And you guys, he was on your shoulder or Eric Turner's shoulder.
Yeah, we did that chicken picking thing where we got up and did the chicken fight.
Yes!
During So Damn Pretty.
That's so much fun.
I don't remember opening for Nazareth because I'm a huge Nazareth fan.
Yeah.
Dan McCarthy is like... He's like, if you listen to old Nazareth and you go, okay, Axel, where'd you get your voice, bro?
Right.
I mean, just saying.
Yeah, but no, I swear to God, you guys opened up for Nazareth in Riverside.
Okay.
And
I remember the theater.
I was blown away because we went there to see Nazareth. We didn't know who was opening. Saw you guys. And then I never forgot your name.
You must have been high.
The odds are there. The odds are there, Joey. Let me tell you.
Full little Maynard quote. You must have been high.
How fun is that? Then I feel
I
almost feel like the proud brother that I've seen. I got to give Joey something to be proud of one of these days. He's doing all this.
I'm proud
cool
of you, brother. That's why I'm here.
I'm proud of you, beautiful.
Okay, I'll take that. Maybe I was just searching for a compliment or something like that.
Compliment whore.
But how cool is that? That I've known him even before
that's
I got in radio.
Cool.
I kind of feel like a stalker, like Misery. Like I'm going to hobble you and keep you in the studio.
Nice. I'm your James Caan, right?
When you got to leave, Joy, when you got to leave.
Yeah.
Actually, it looks like Jimbo's fanning out a little bit here.
A little bit. No, but I'm excited about this. Like I said, that you guys just signed your record deal. How long did it take? When did Warrant form, and how long did it take to get your record deal?
Band got together in 84. Eric Turner and I, Eric started the band. We're in a band here in Orange County in like 82. And then I went off to one band. He went off to L.A., started Warrant and in 84. And then I moved up there to Hollywood in like 86 maybe. And then in 87, I literally ran into him on the corner of Sunset and Doheny. And it was when Eric and Jerry and Janie and Steven were together, and Janie he wanted a new lead guitar player.
Right.
And I literally ran into him one night, and he's like, oh my God, I haven't seen you in a year or two, and we're looking for a lead guitar player. And about a year later, we got a deal.
That's
so
magic.
I always tell the guys, hey, it was me, babe.
Yeah, I'm your rabbit's foot.
I'm the thumb and the fist. Yeah. You know what I mean? Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, what's that feeling like? Like when you signed that record deal, how old were you?
Shit, it was 88, so I don't 24.
Okay.
Wow. Yeah.
And you're signing that paper.
Yeah, with Columbia, the biggest label in the world.
Yeah. Are you in that office and they got champagne and
it
everything?
It was really, it wasn't a big deal. I mean, we were in the studio, I think, making the record, and they're like, you got the contract's ready, go over. And we went over to the top floor of CBS Records in Century City, and there was a few lawyers there. The guy that signed us, Ron Oberman, who just passed a few weeks ago, rest his soul, you know, And we signed it, and I think we went out and had a few beers, and that was it. So it was really anticlimactic, believe it or not.
Huh.
You know what I mean? Even getting the deal, the night we got the deal, Janie had chicken pox.
Oh, shit.
And we had an abbreviated show because he was dying.
Yeah.
And that's the show that got us signed, which
when
is
did,
weird,
when
right?
did it really hit you that, holy shit?
It didn't until MTV.
Oh,
when
right.
we got into rotation,
it.
Down Boys.
Oh, I loved it so
much.
And then one day, I had one of those Mazda B2000s. Remember those beauties?
Oh, hell yeah.
I had some badass Alpine shit in there. And I you know, I had our tape in there
uh-huh.
before it was released, but I had it in, and I turned my car on. And Down Boys was on, and I thought that the tape was in,
yeah.
But it was the first time I ever heard us on the radio.
No shit.
I went to like fast forward it because I'm like, I heard that song too fucking much. It wasn't in there. I'm like, ah! But yeah, so I mean, it just, you know, it goes so fast. It was a fucking roller coaster ride.
Yeah, I bet.
You
know? Wow. Once the rocket took off, it blasted.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun for about 5 years, and then it got not so fun.
Oh.
You know, the dark years, as we call them. The Seattle, which I love some Seattle bands. I love me some Soundgarden.
Oh, you always talk about that. That was a tough part.
We're going to get into that in a little bit, I think. You know, fuck it. Let's get into it right now.
Yeah,
because you always say it ruined your life.
Here's how it ruined it.
If you weren't supposed to say that in public. Oh.
That's just an inside thing that we talk about.
It ruined getting laid a little bit more, I think. Now, here's the thing. I grew up in Chicago. I moved out here to California in 87.
Okay.
And I got into radio in 91, but MTV was like, we would have parties just for Headbangers Ball.
Right.
Like, everybody would come to the guy who could afford cable, and we would have parties and watch MTV Headbangers Ball.
Some Schaefer and some Konchaka vodka, right?
I mean, like, how fun was the MTV era?
It was great when you were on it. I mean, it was fucking crazy, yeah. It was, I don't even know what to say. I mean, we when you go on the road and you do a video, you know, it's the most beating thing you can ever do in your life because you're sitting there for like 16 hours and you're shooting like 1 hour, you do like one take.
Right.
And then you're sitting there for an hour and then you do another take and it's hot as shit. Anyways, but when, you know, you do the video and once it's out and you go on tour, you're on tour.
Yeah.
You're gone. So it's just fucking gig, bus, sleep,
you're
party,
away from
gig,
reality a little bit.
Yeah.
You just got to do what you got to do.
You don't watch TV because you're never around a live TV.
So you're not
you
seeing
know.
The impact that you're having
no, you're
quite
getting
yet.
Phone calls from people. Oh, you're number one on dial. What was it? Dial MTV. I don't remember what the fuck it was called. But we did.
Who were you opening up for at that time after the first album?
We finished the first record with supporting Motley Crue on the Dr. Feelgood tour. We did 86 dates with them.
Damn, what a time that must have been.
Dude, that band was on... That was probably the best they were, I think, in their career. They were just
I don't think it was
fire.
Their best album, but I think it was the tour
they
where
were sober.
Everybody...
They were sober for a while.
Right.
I was there when they became unsober.
Was that good for you or bad for you?
It was great.
Yeah.
It was. I was at a strip club called the Gold Club in Atlanta.
Uh-huh.
Tommy Lee and me. And a bunch of bodyguards, and we were up in the champagne lounge, and I'm like, I'll take a shot of Jack and a beer. And he's across from me, he's going, two. He's fuck, you're sober, dude. I'm not gonna be that guy. And I'm like, I'm sorry, I got an alcohol problem. I'll take two. And so I pounded one, and then I go, I gotta piss. And I took my other one and went into the bathroom and Tommy was running in. You know, I held the door and he's like, oh my god, oh fuck. But that's what I remember. I watched the dirt and I'm like, if that was what it was supposed to be, it didn't go down that way.
Now, is there any? Speaking of the dirt, is there any thought of maybe doing the Warrant story?
I don't know, dude. It's. I mean, we lost one guy. God bless him. And I don't know. It'd be real tough. I don't know if there's enough of a story there to tell. There's definitely some fun times.
Yeah,
sure.
You know, we just. We're just a workhorse, man. We just get out and play live shows and occasionally make a record. So I don't know. We'll see.
Okay.
Some guy in Chicago is talking about it.
I know. We'd like that. You know, I think, tell me what you think about this. I think the dirt messed up. It was great, but I think it could have been like a mini series. There could have been like 6 to 8 episodes at least of the whole career.
Yeah.
Instead
like
of just
on
one
Netflix.
Big
like, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's interesting. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know if they made it and they looked for, you know, just a different distribution or what. I don't know any of that shit in the movies, you know?
Yeah. Well, I got them the reunion tour.
You know, God bless them. I hope they go out and kick ass. We had a good time with them, you know, they're
I know
a great
they will.
Band. Yeah. I mean, it's a great package.
And some people get angry. I don't give a shit. Like, there's so many times where people are like, they said they were going to retire and I paid extra money to go see that retirement tour because I thought it was the last show. It's never the last fucking show.
Fuck, who's bitching about a rock band coming out on
tour?
You know what I mean?
I mean, as far as at least with my life, Ozzy was the first one I know that said the no more tours. And then he's had the next year or two, it said retirement sucks tour. So I was like, it's too much fucking money, too much fun.
There's business people helping you make those decisions, you know?
Yeah.
And the band, to be honest with you, in a band, it's like being married to four other people, right?
Right.
And it's fucking hard. You know what I mean? Yeah. To like maintain and not want to beat the fuck out of each other.
Or three. You know?
Three times.
Or
three, yeah, yeah. Okay, great. You know? I'm on number two, so.
Two times a charm.
Great, I love it. Yeah, it is. It is. But, you know, it's just hard, so I get it. I think they were fucking toast. They wanted to be done. And if everybody wants to see them, I hope they go out and just kick everybody in the ass. Yeah.
The lineups kick ass.
It's
let's be honest.
It's great, yeah.
You know, between Def Leppard, Poison, and then
Joan Jett, too. Jones is a sleeper, dude. Joan's going to kick everybody's ass,
yep.
I think.
She's going to raise the bar
a
little bit.
Yeah.
Have you ever punched any of your bandmates in the face?
Not in the face, no.
No?
No, I've stirred their beer with my cock.
Ooh, we got to try that, beautiful.
It's called a cocktail.
Do we want to put any names to that, or we're just going to leave it?
I might have been a singer, I don't know. I'm partial to the singer, dude.
Did it get rid of the syphilis? No, I'm
kidding. I don't know. It might have. I think it was chlamydia.
Okay.
That and a few 10 milligrams of doxycycline will clear that shit right up.
Shit. Damn. I don't know what question prompted that, but I'm glad we got that answer. That's fucking
hilarious.
Let me
know when this is going to air so I tell my wife not to watch this shit.
Yeah. We tell all our kids to subscribe to this, but don't listen to
it. Tell all your friends, not listen.
Right? Shit.
Yeah, I told my kids when we started the podcast, I said, Mommy's starting a podcast with Jimbo. Subscribe to it. Tell all your friends, but do not fucking listen. You're not going to like what comes out of Mommy's mouth.
Or in it.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, you got the swear jar at home?
No, we haven't caught them swearing. Not Jim. Mine are grown. I talked to my grown kids and told them not to listen.
Okay, yeah. I got a 28-year-old daughter who's beautiful. God bless her. Hello, honey. And then I've got a 7-year-old son that's just up my ass. Every time I go, shh, he's like, I heard that. And I'm like, right?
He's waiting.
I'm like, dude, let me tell you something. I'm going to give you a swear minute once a week.
That's
and
pretty.
He's all, really?
I've never heard of
really?
That.
Really? Yeah, swear
that's
minute.
That's cool.
And so he comes in, and he's all fired up. He's all, can I do it now? I'm all, yeah. And he goes, fuck, 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 motherfucker, 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 shit, 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 shit. Just over and over, and it's great, dude. It's a lot of fun to watch a 7-year-old do
can
that.
Can I steal that?
Absolutely.
We can do that with your kids.
Let's do it.
That'll get out some aggression, I think.
Yeah, because
And everybody laughs, and then you go on, and, you know.
That's right hilarious. Yeah. I love that story, Joey.
Because there was that one track on your second album
where you guys
did a compilation.
Ode to Tipper Gore.
Yes.
Yeah, that thing came. We did a live show, and they had to pare it down for Westwood One.
Right.
And they took all the engineer took all the swear words out, and it made like a minute of just, you know, that. Blowjob, who to get a blowjob? Fuck, 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 shit, shit, shit. And then that was when Tipper Gore was trying to do the PMRC
thing.
Look
that up, guys, if you can find that. It's Ode to Tipper Gore. If we can find that, that'd be cool.
She was doing the PMRC thing, and we said, fuck you, here. Yeah. And then when it came out, we got the sticker.
Was that
because
the,
of that?
Yeah. Was that the time D. Snyder?
That was when D went in and you know, so well
read
spoke.
Him the riot.
Yeah,
act.
He spoke so well. It was great, you know.
Hilarious.
Good fun.
Oh, I think we got it.
We got it.
All right.
Shit.
This is, I don't think Jackie's ever heard this, but get ready for a joyride.
Wait, my kid's in the studio, is it okay?
Yeah, it's
earmuffs. Earmuffs.
There's no X-rated stuff in here. There you go.
You guys kick
ass.
Is that a hilarious track or what?
Ode to Tipper Gore, 1990. Yep.
And I want you to know, back in my radio days, that inspired me to do something called the the belch wars. Every time I had to burp, I would burp into our microphone and save it on a digital tape.
Nice. And,
and I just like cut out the space and just had like a minute long. And I stole that from you guys that we would play every now and then. Isn't that fucking hilarious?
That's great.
Hilarious.
Warren equals goddamn fun is what
yeah,
it goes.
Yeah, they do.
So many great songs. Yeah. And I've lined it up. I want to go through the history and... You know, just give us a little snippet of what you thought. We're gonna start. Oh, here we go. Let's bring it.
Shit.
This is the very first hit. Down Boys. Was that the song that really, really opened the world up to you?
Yeah, this song was top 40 song. It was the first song I ever played with the band when I auditioned.
Jackie, look at Joey. He's the one on the far right.
Look at I'm holding my belt like it's my cock.
Oh my!
And, I'm about 70 pounds lighter there with hair. What the fuck? What happened?
I'm looking at Jimbo's picture on the wall.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh my god.
Yeah. I'm like, he's got
in that band.
Yeah.
Look at same hair, but he's still got hair.
He's got a hairway to heaven, just like Jim.
Look at that.
Oh, that was me when I met you in '91, actually.
Freaking
I remember you now.
Now you remember.
Jack, don't you owe him $5?
Hey, go back to Joey's picture quick.
Shit.
And Jackie, what do you got to say?
I said he's got a hairway to heaven, just like Jim.
He's a man. He has a hairy chest. He's a man. Do you manscape it all off, or do you still got it?
Oh, fuck. I tighten that shit up. Yeah, my wife would kick my ass, dude.
Shit. I remember when I was like in fourth grade, I was listening to Kiss Alive, looking at it. And I'm like, oh, I want a chest like Paul Stanley.
Yeah, Janie used to say, the only man in rock and roll that's got more hair on his chest than Paul Stanley, blah, blah, blah. And then one time we did a gig, and we were on tour with Maiden in Europe. And listen to this bill. Who doesn't belong on this bill? Pantera,
okay.
Warrant,
uh-huh.
Testament, Megadeth, Iron Maiden, and Black Sabbath.
How'd you guys get on there?
We were touring with Maiden. So it was like Monsters of Rock in Milan, Italy. So I get off stage, and Vinny Paul's all, God bless you, Vinny. He's all
him.
Fucking hammered, and he's like, hey, man, you shave that shit, right? You keep that tight? And I'm like, yeah, bro, take it easy. And like an hour later, he was sleeping in his bus because he was so fucking hammered. So, yeah.
How'd the crowd respond to Warrant on that one?
They threw shit at us. It was great.
What'd you get hit with?
Just fucking bottles of piss, and it was good
shit.
Fun. And then as an encore, we did Balls to the Wall by Accept, and
yes.
We had them fucking rock, and we left.
And you were accepted.
We're like, fuck you, Italy. Thank you very much. It's online. You can see it. Dimebag comes out and sings Down Boys with us. It's fucking great.
Hate when people throw shit or they do those goddamn laser pointers.
Yeah, that's
up
scary.
On the stage.
That's scary shit.
Because that's like a scope. You're like, is somebody fucking...
you don't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's scary.
I hate, like, look at me, I'm on the stage. My laser point's on the stage.
Yeah, and you're kind of stuck up there like a fucking target, you know?
Yeah.
But it is what it is.
Damn.
You know?
That's awesome.
Look at that.
And that's a band right now, Jackie.
Look at that sexy bald man.
I know, that's even hotter, to be honest.
Look at Mr. Clean all buff and shit.
Fucking look at Steve-O looks like fucking Johnny Depp. Fucking pirate boy.
Yep, and there's Jerry Dixon on the far right. That was the guy who did who came to the station and did the fun with Warrant at the radio station.
Yeah, that looks like we're laughing, having a good time. That was in Chicago, I think.
And there's Eric Turner.
Yep. Turner the Burner.
Yeah, badass man. We love Eric.
You guys look awesome.
We look like we're having
I
a good time,
it.
Right?
Fuck yeah. Were you having a good time there?
Fuck yeah.
All right, good.
Always in Chicago.
Hell yeah. That's
maybe you should shave your head, honey.
I don't know if I could do it.
Well, you've tried to grow it for the past 8 years.
The more hair you lose, the more head you get, brother.
Amen, brother. It's a solar panel for a sex machine. Is what I heard. Damn, well, you guys look good.
Hell yeah.
And, I mean, to be honest, I mean, you look in better shape there.
You do.
Than when you started.
I pumped up, you know.
Yeah, look at you. Was it hard for you to learn guitar, or is that something that came easy to you?
Dude, I started on tennis racket with the, remember
really?
The dog ear, remember the, are you old enough to know what dog ear antennas
are?
Right?
Oh, yeah.
The dog ears with the mic stand.
Every time we ate a ding-dong, we had to take the tinfoil and put
on
the head so
you
get more reception.
Yeah, get better reception.
Yep.
So that with Kiss Alive in like 75, I was like 11. And then I started playing guitar in like fifth grade, the catgut. Uh-huh. And I'm feeling groovy. Ding, 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 ding. And then just got into Smoke on the Water, was the first one. And then Van Halen came out in like 79.
Was that the band that really made you say
shit? Edward, I was just like, what the fuck is this? You know? And then I just got into it.
Can you play Eruption?
No.
No. To this day?
I just don't. There's like people, there's like 10-year-olds online that can just shred it. I'm not a copy guy. I you know what? In my career, I didn't play it. I did for a little bit in the beginning, like did Van Halen, Cheap Trick, you know, stuff like that. But I never got into it. I was always just playing your own tunes. So
I told Jim, I said, you missed your calling, honey. You needed to be on a rock band.
There you
He's
go.
Got all Singer. The stage presence,
Singer.
Man.
Yeah.
Just that
he really
thing
does.
Can't sing. But some
There's
people
a certain
say
amount
David
of
Roth
narcissism singers have.
I know.
That you have.
Yes, yes.
But no, it's a good thing. If you have the perfect amount, then you're great. You know, if you have too much, you're fucked. If you don't have enough, you're fucked.
There's
you're
moments the I right think partner. I could still start a punk rock band.
Punk's great. I saw something on the news today. I watched the news for like 10 minutes in the morning. Some punk rock band played in Wacko, maybe is their name. They played in a Long Beach Denny's, and they beat the shit out of the Denny's, and they're suing them, and there's like a GoFundMe to get some money. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it was killer. I'm like, yeah, it still lives.
Well, damn, that was a kick-ass story about the Down Boys. Let's go to one of Jackie's favorites. Go ahead and strike up a little bit, would you, Ashton? Number two.
It makes me want to get naked, man.
All right.
Did many girls get naked to this for you guys?
Never happened.
Never.
Right on.
This is a badass song. And I like this one because you guys, in the video, you had some choreographed moves like the old school Kiss.
Fucking really?
And you guys had, did you guys wear, is that the white leather?
It wasn't my idea.
Okay.
It was not my idea. I don't know whose fucking idea that was. That white leather shit.
I think it's okay, man.
Dude, and all the names. Like we looked like the fucking banana splits. You know what I mean?
We love bananas.
Let's blame it on Columbia Records.
They picked your outfits for that?
No, we did.
Okay.
But it wasn't my idea. I just went along with it.
Did you? Okay.
I didn't give a fuck. I was drinking and smoking.
Fucking put on a kilt. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm in Warrant, goddamn.
Yeah. That song, here's a good story about that song. When we were doing pre-production for the first record with Bo Hill, our producer at the time, he didn't want to record that record or that song.
Really?
Yeah, he did. He's like, I don't think so. And we're like, dude, in our clubs, you know, the Whiskey, the Rainbow.
Yeah.
Not the Rainbow, the Roxy, you know, the Troubadour, all those gigs we played. That was the song where everybody just went nuts.
Like, it was a moment.
We got to put that one on the record.
It changed
you know?
It up a little bit.
Yeah.
Because going to a concert's a journey.
Yeah. The demo versions of that are a lot heavier than that turned out on the record. It went... What, number one on the Rolling Stone charts for 2 months, and then number two on the Hot 100, which was the charts back in the year, right?
Yeah.
Back in the day. Maybe they
Did
still have now.
Did Casey Kasem ever get
know.
To say, and here's more.
Yeah.
Oh,
do you know what's
awesome.
Funny is, you know who was number one that beat us out? Milli Vanilli.
What?
No shit.
Fake
no shit.
News. Fake news.
Yeah,
news.
Right. Fake news, motherfuckers.
Damn.
Yeah. Motherfuckers.
And that's why Damn. You went to the CHRs because of heaven.
Right.
Because they were picking it up.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you get to go to the coast in LA?
Probably. I don't fucking remember.
That's a good makeout jam, though. I'm sure a lot
we
of guys got the third base in the
we
concert.
We call those songs the panty wetters.
Yeah.
That's what
yeah.
we call them.
Yep. I know.
Yes. And then this next one, Fired Up, because this one gives
Blast
a...
from the past. There you go. That's more my style.
Look at that guitar. Yeah! The video was kind of dark, wasn't it?
This was dark. A guy named Mert Avis did that video, and that was the shortest video shoot ever, and it was fucking killer.
Nice.
It's like 6 hours. You guys are done. We're like, fucking love you, man.
And that one had an impact because that one, wasn't that one after Heaven? So, like, didn't it, like, it was like people were like, oh,
that was actually after
that
Cherry
band.
Pie. So we did four off the first record, which Heaven was on the first record, and then when Cherry Pie came out, Cherry Pie was the first video, and then Uncle Tom's was the second.
What a so, jam. That one fucking
that's
shreds.
That's fun when good. We still play that live, and that's that. I never get tired of playing that tune.
That's a fun one.
I love
one.
All y'all songs, honey. It's
dude,
so
thank you.
Fucking
thank
awesome.
You.
And, really I'm a, country girl. I love
oh, God
all
bless
your stuff.
Oh, we're getting
love
to that.
I love it.
And this is so another good. Panty
awesome,
dropper.
Thank you.
You want to fire up the next one, Ashton?
Oh, there you go.
Is that a fun riff to play?
That's Eric.
There's Eric right there.
Can I think he likes it.
Can you see the looks of girls' panties melting off when you, you hear that when you start this one? Damn.
Oh my God.
We got the lighters going.
Nice little Bic lighter going on.
We got the creeps in the front row getting to third base with their chicks with the mini skirts.
About right now, I'm wanting the song to end so I can have a sip of my cocktail.
Oh my God.
A little, I got a little so tequila good. And ice and a little beer sitting there. I'm like, fucking nah. Come on, motherfuckers. Finish the shit.
And then fire up the next jam, which was every strip club on planet Earth. Cherry pie, baby.
Take it off, motherfucker.
Watch take your most good nigga, baby.
He takes wooden nickels, just so you know. Producer Mark. Oh, he just showed Areola.
He only takes coins, ladies and gentlemen. Coins. Coins only.
Somebody's been hitting the Manischewitz again, it looks like. We need a camera in our sound booth.
Hell yeah, we do.
Now, how cool is it? You had to have gotten a lap dance to Cherry Pie sometime.
I don't remember
life.
Shit.
Well, Jim's getting one
I
tonight.
Mean, good. You guys video it and send, send
yeah.
the PG version
We're gonna
to me.
Do that.
Just send the audio to me. That's all I need.
Now, Cherry Pie, when you guys recorded that, did you say, fucking mega hit?
No, the record was done. And it was going to be called either Quality You Can Taste or Uncle Tom's Cabin. And the president of Columbia Records called us or called Janie and said, I want to love in an elevator because they had just signed Aerosmith. Yeah. He said, okay. And he wrote that song, I think, in 15 minutes. And he wrote the lyrics on a Domino's pizza box.
No shit.
And I was at a golf tournament. I used to play golf.
Yeah, nice.
Don't anymore, but... with Jerry in like Colorado, and they called us and played like a 8-track demo of it.
Uh-huh.
You got to get back here now, and we got on a plane the next day and went back and recorded it.
What a fucking life!
Damn.
Yeah, it was fun.
That's cool.
Yeah, and then we you don't fucking know. I don't.
I mean,
know.
Did you think it was weird? Like Cherry Pie? What the fuck?
I don't fucking know. It's you just go in and you play. You know,
yeah.
You just do it. You don't know what song's gonna be. What? It's such a tangled web. On you got promo guys for radio. You got promo guys,
you're
product
pretty good
manager.
With the flow guy, ain't you?
Yeah, you just there's such a huge team of people that are responsible for that success, that you can't do it without them. And it's like going into a meeting boardroom with 30 people. What's going to be the first single, Bob? What's going to be the first single? And I'm back there fucking high as a kite going, I don't fucking care.
Fuck, just pick one.
Yeah, let's go on tour. Fuck it.
Is there a song that you guys did that you thought would make it and didn't, or vice versa?
The third record that we made, Dog Eat Dog, with Michael Wagner, is a heavier, darker record, and it sounds
He's
better
done what?
Than,
Great White? He's done Guns N' Roses?
Skid Row. Both first two Skid Row records, Extreme. He mixed, I think, some Michael Jackson stuff. He's done a bunch of stuff. He mixed Metallica and For Justice and All, or whatever the fuck that record is. I'm not a big Metallica guy, even though I was in a band with Lars way back
no
when.
No shit.
Way oh. back when, before Metallica. But anyways, he's done a lot. So we did a record, and it was right when the Seattle thing was going on.
Yeah.
And it kind of got squashed, but there was a song on there called Hole in My Wall that was about voyeurism. That would have been a killer video, like segue from Cherry Pie.
Yeah.
Nice.
Some guy looking through the hole of his
little
wall.
Little Porkies.
Yeah, and it's like an X-rated Disneyland lyrics. It's fucking killer.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, it's very dark.
Well,
let's go
first
live that
thing
one.
I thought of was Glory Hole.
Kind of the same thing.
Ashton, fire up the next one if you don't mind. I saw red and I closed the door. Great song. Was this a CHR hit too?
Yeah.
So dramatic. I love dramatic songs.
Yeah, yeah, we're making a lot of love tonight. Janie was when we get home, baby.
Yeah, put them on. Janie was a great songwriter, and yeah, that one was a good one. We used to call it on the road, "I saw Fred," because Fred was the code word for cocaine, Dewey. So it'd be like, "Has anybody seen? Got any Fred? Have you seen Fred?" I saw Fred. Okay. Okay.
And you want to see Fred again.
Well, when you're 28 on tour and yeah. you're fucking. You
the know, hours are a
why
mother.
Why not? Who gives a fuck?
Why not?
Yeah.
I saw Fred. How fucking fun is that? Now, I got to ask you, when Janie left the band, did any of the other guys want to leave with him? Or was
no.
it just like a divide that it was either.
He wanted to do a solo thing. We were doing the Dog Eat Dog tour, and it went from arenas to theaters, and we were still filling theaters.
Mm-hmm.
But Seattle was taking hold, and rightfully so. I mean, it was time for a change.
Some great songs, but the chick's outfit sucked for grunge.
Yeah, it was a little disappointing.
Yeah,
you
it's
know?
Like, wow, yeah. that girl's wearing the same pants as the guy who changed my oil.
Yeah, it is what it is, you know. But,
fucking dickies.
But change is good, and there were some great bands out of Seattle. So,
oh, no doubt.
I mean, I think he just wanted to branch out on his own, but I think he did it the wrong way and had some bad direction from some business people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he could have just said, let's finish this tour. And then I want to go away for 2 years and do my own thing, and we would have been fine. You know, everybody do their thing.
Right.
But he split in the middle of it, and it
the Stones
it got
did
dark.
It. They did it a bunch
yeah,
of times.
It got dark. That's when it got dark. Yeah,
man.
I'd split. That's when I left the band.
Man,
like 95
or
96.
Sad, sad day.
It sucked, but looking back on it, for me, it was self-preservation. I went back to school for like 8 years. I was a database admin, just geeked out.
Yeah,
you know, the whole pleated pants, you know, collared
no
shirt. And then when it came back around for me in 2004,
was that the job that made you shave your head?
No. It was just what you do. You know, I had a daughter. I was trying to make money, and
yeah,
and I didn't want to be. I thought I probably, if I stayed in the band at that time, I probably wouldn't be here because it was dark and it was party. It wasn't good. And so I did that. And when I came back, you know, it was what 15, 16 years ago now, and it's doing great, better than ever. Yeah,
love it. Do you miss your hair?
No.
No.
No, I don't. I don't give.
Jim misses his.
I do miss mine.
I'm the most unaffected guy. I don't. I'm just a dude, you know, that plays guitar and I have a great time and I love my brothers and my band. I love my friends like you and I don't give a fuck, you know, if I've got hair or not. Really, I don't give a shit.
Aw, it makes me want to lose my extension.
I got more hair in my ears than I do on my fucking head, all right?
I love all the hair on Jim. I told him when I met him.
Some women like that shit.
Just real quick, when I first met Jim, he's got all this hair all over his body.
Like Joey.
Like, and he's like, it doesn't bother you. But I was like, honey, your hair all flows in the same direction. It's so beautiful.
That's nice.
All
Look at
it.
That. This is love fest, man. I
it's
love
it. It's Jimbo and Jackie
that.
Show.
I love it.
Third time's
God
a
bless
charm.
You guys.
Do you know why we call it Third Time's
time.
A Charm?
Because the third time you guys met each other, you were fucking hooked up and it was great. I don't know.
We saw Fred. No, we're actually on our third marriage.
Each of us.
Okay.
So that's why we call it Third Time's a Charm.
I've done it twice.
Yeah.
So Second Time's a Charm.
Yeah,
good for you.
And you know what? My ex-wife's cool. We've got a beautiful daughter together. She came to a few shows this year. I did New Orleans and Biloxi. She comes out and has a good time. We're cool.
Yep. Our saying over here is we may be losers, but we ain't quitters.
Yeah,
and
that's right. Yeah. I've been with my wife 23 years, married 14 this year.
Awesome.
Congrats. What does she do?
She's a mom.
Yeah,
you know,
that's awesome.
She was an anchor. She was in construction. She built she was the project manager on the two largest, the towers over here, the 25-story towers at the 55 and the 405.
Oh, wow.
No shit.
She worked for a developer and a construction company, and then she got out of that, and she's, you know, we've got a 7-year-old son, so that's what she does.
Oh, badass.
She's really good at it.
Very cool.
Jim and I met at Chuck E. Cheese.
Nice. Really? No shit?
In Victorville.
How's that, my nephew?
Was he Chucky or what?
Yeah, that was my other gig.
He was about 5 hours later.
Nice.
Nice shit. Yeah, I was at my nephew's birthday party, and she was friends with his mom.
See?
Yeah.
And
I had thought about this guy for 16 years before I got the touch.
That's pressure,
oh,
dude.
Oh, wow. No shit.
Had seen him 2 times, but had never met him, talked to him, anything.
That's great. That's a great story.
Bro, she told me that our first makeout session, we're like in the middle of it, and she says that. I've waited 16, and I'm my divorce papers haven't even dried
I
yet.
I remember, dude.
And I'm like, holy shit.
Yeah, I'd met him at Chuck
E. Cheese.
He messages me and says, hey, you want to go to a party with me tonight? And I'm like, and I was sick as a dog. I'm like, I'm not missing out on a date with this man. And 5 hours later, we're at my house in bed.
Yep.
Yeah.
Touching. Fucking balls to the wall, man. I am not.
Balls to the sugar wall, so to speak. But we went to, it was kind of cool because I got to invite her to the drummer of Great White, Audie's.
I know Audie, yeah, he's a good guy.
Great guy. I got got to invite, I'm like, hey, you want to go to Chris's party? It's for the drummer of Great White.
Yeah.
Lured her right in.
Nice.
But the guys, they're still making music, and we got the latest one, Ashton. Fire up. Come on! What happened there? Don't take a nap on me, bro.
Pardon me, folks. We're experiencing technical difficulties. Set this town on fire tonight. She got one thing on her mind. All she can get, I know she'll find it. Louder, harder, faster. Give it the gain. Louder, harder, faster.
I heard you, Joey. You sound damn good.
Damn. Louder, harder, faster. It's fun. That was a fun one.
Yes.
You know? Not to be confused with Harder, Faster by April Wine now.
No, don't.
You know? And Miles is a good friend of the band, and April Wine's badass. Great Canadian band. But yeah, good record. A lot of fun. Jeff Pilson, Dokken fame, right?
Yep.
Bass player. He produced it. He's in Foreigner. He's all the MD for Foreigner.
Badass.
So a lot of fun, man. A lot of fun making that record. It was one of those records where everybody puts their songs in a big hat and everybody votes. And then there was one song in there that Robert didn't like. And he's like, fuck, I'm not going to sing this song if it gets picked. And I'm like, well, then rewrite it, dude.
Yeah.
You know, don't complain. Just come in with an answer. And he did. And it was like the second song on the record. It's about this devil senorita stripper with stripper poles and shit. It's fucking great.
Man.
Yeah.
You're a fucking team player.
A lot of fun. Dude, yeah, I just chill.
Yeah. I love that about you,
why
Joey.
Not?
And Jackie learned something earlier today. Fire up the next one because this one, Jackie was really shocked.
Oh, yeah.
Jackie's got a story about this one. That's a cover, isn't it?
Yes, Merle.
Merle Haggard.
Merle Haggard.
Did you guys get to meet him when you covered this?
No, we did this. We were branding with Pro Bull Riders Association.
Great idea, whoever it was. And it was yours, probably.
We did a bunch of gigs for them. They sell out 27 arenas a year. So we did that song for them, did a video for them, played a bunch of. We play the finals most every year. We didn't this year because we had another gig, but next year I think we're going to.
Badass.
And we love the PBR. We love the sport. If you ever watch it, it's insane.
Yeah,
you know, 2,500 pound bull with a 130-pound dude riding that shit, and they jump 10, 12 feet in the air.
I've been right on
the cages. Literally. We went when they were over here in Anaheim. We went down there. It was part of the video shoot.
Yeah.
And you're on the shoot, and these bulls are just fucking massive, bro. They're huge, and they're throwing those fucking guys off, you know.
Have you ever done a mechanical bull?
Probably, but I don't remember.
I love it. But Jackie's got a story about Merle Haggard.
Well, I'm a country girl. I grew up in North Carolina, Missouri, so
nice.
I was always at the tavern with my dad.
Okay.
And Merle Haggard was huge, and they played him all the time on the jukebox. And so they'd put that song on, and I'd be dancing as a little girl, and they'd be throwing out little dollars and quarters. And I'm surprised I didn't become a stripper because of that.
Dancing a cherry pie, baby.
Right?
Nice.
I love Merle Haggard. That's badass.
Yeah, it was great cover to do for us, great video, and we had a lot of fun. So PBR rocks.
Yeah, nice. Yeah. Jim played that today. I was like, oh my God, they covered Merle Haggard? That's badass.
That is a badass idea. Yep. And that's the thing, keeping it going.
Yeah.
You know, trying new things, that's what it should be about, man.
Absolutely.
You're an artist.
Yeah. Absolutely, man. That and just touring, you know, we beat it to death, so we're having fun.
Do you have a favorite guitar face you like to make while you're up there on stage?
I don't know what I look like up there, dude.
Do you ever see some videos and go, what the fuck was that?
Yeah, I don't. I don't watch myself at all. I just fucking...
Because I got to be honest, sometimes I do stand-up every now and then.
Right.
And my favorite thing is to talk about guitar faces.
Okay.
And I try to equate it to the ladies, and I say, That's the only job you can make these fucked up faces.
Right.
Can you imagine if you went to your gynecologist and all of a sudden, you know, Dr. Jellyfingers goes in there and he goes...
Yeah, right? You're in jail.
You're in jail.
I don't know, man. I just get up and play and have a good time.
You feel
man.
The music.
Yeah, that's it. Sometimes you close your eyes. Look, we've been playing the same fucking songs for 30 years. You got to get a little buzzed sometimes just to make it fun. No, I'm joking.
What's your favorite song? If somebody came up to you that was like a young cat and said, Warrant, why should I know Warrant? What's the one song you say, check out this song, and it says who we are?
I don't know. Maybe Uncle Tom's Cabin.
It's because a badass
jam. It's just got a cool story. It's from about
and
down
rocks.
South. Yeah. I mean, if you listen to most of our stuff, it's blues-based, you know?
Yeah.
And that song's definitely blues-based, so a lot of fun.
Well, I got an idea for you.
All right.
In case if you're hurting for money, which I know you're not, but if it ever comes to that, I think I got a deal. I can get you an endorsement deal with a company. They're basically known for hair removal for ladies.
Okay.
And I'd like to sing it to you and see if this interests you at all.
Okay.
So this is like when you're a little bit older and maybe need a little extra cash.
Because
even Zeppelin has given songs to Cadillac and stuff
like
that.
Yes, they have, yeah.
Okay, so this is for women who need to shave a little bit.
Okay.
Okay?
Tighten it up.
She's my hairy pie. Got a big wolf pussy. She just can't hide. Wool so tough, makes my nose hairs fry. Sweet hairy pie.
Nice.
That big old wolf pussy.
It's
Where's that fucking from, wolf pussy?
Where the fuck's that from, Ashton?
Friday after next.
Oh my God.
So that's an
option.
Sounds
like Samuel Jackson. Is that Samuel Jackson?
We've got Bush.
That's my personal retirement plan for you.
All right.
We need to make some extra cash,
All right.
I'll sell you that.
You
for
can produce
minimal.
And direct. I'm in.
Amen, brother. All right. Joey. I love you, man.
I love you too, brother.
I love you too, Joey.
I love you, Jackie.
Hug it out. Hug it out. We can't thank you enough for being part of episode 41.
Love it.
I hope you dig the studio.
I do. I dig it.
I know
I
you got
it.
A lot of rock star friends, so please tell them, hey.
I'll let them
know.
Go
speak your mind at Ram Studios.
I'll let them know. You bring some in. Well, you know, we'll do it again. Let's do it again in a year or two, and we'll bring Robert in and play a little music for
Let's
you.
Let's do it, yeah. Awesome. And we got a full-blown studio in the back.
It's a badass
show you
studio.
Where we can set up whatever you want and anything like that. I think 2020 is going to continue to be successful for you. Well,
thank you, brother. Thank you.
We hope it's for us because we haven't found
Me
success
too.
Yet.
Yeah.
We're looking.
50 and fucked a little.
Shit,
that was almost
right.
The name of the show. We're
going to
call it 50 and fucked. But everybody told me we can't put that on billboards.
We're still alive. Fuck it.
That's right.
You know, you wake up every day breathing. It's going to be good.
And we got you here, honey.
You did.
Aww. It's a celebration.
I'm glad I finally made it.
I'm glad
I finally made it, man.
Joey, God bless you.
Me. Thank you.
God bless Warren. Let's keep the party going. 2020's alive. We're going to have a lot of fun and do some things together.
Absolutely.
And, if you could play a little cherry pie, Jackie's got a little wish list.
We love to do Lady and the Tramp style.
We end the show with us doing Lady and the Tramp. If you could play a little cherry pie as Joey gets awkward and we...
Well, that's not exactly a cherry pie. Our budget.
We got a Pop-Tart.
Is that a cherry Pop-Tart?
We got a Pop-Tart.
That's nice.
We can only afford one Pop-Tart.
So,
nice.
We're going to play a little cherry pie. Take us out, and Jackie and I, thank you, Joey Allen.
Thank you for having me, man.
Man, you're badass. Keep life going.
What the fuck's going on here?
We'll do some cool shit together as we end episode 41 of the Jimbo and Jackie Show.
Third time's a charm.
We'll see you next week. Enjoy YouTube. Subscribe. Share. Do it all. We love you guys. Say goodbye, Jackie.
Bye-bye, y'all.
See ya.
That's great. Yeah.
Joey Allen forever, baby.
Damn, that's good.
All right, you can take us out, Ashton. I got pop tart all over the shit.
I say, welcome y'all now. Come on in to the Jimbo and Jack Show. You know, he's that crazy kooky guy used to be on the radio.
For a little bit.
She's really sweet and her face is neat. They put it up on a big billboard. They're too much fun, so the previous marriages ended in divorce.
No!
But third time. charm.
Yeah, come on in.
They say the third time's charm.
That's what they say.
Long live Jimbo and Jackie. Ah-ha!
Love you, Joey.
Nice.
Was that fun?
That was great.